Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, welcome to the house of the Lord. Thank you. Welcome to the house of the Lord. We bless him. We bless him. We bless him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for making it this afternoon to this special moment of celebration and thanksgiving. Amen. Praise God. I'd like to introduce our guests and those who are visiting today. And after that, we're going to have a special dance. And I will come and introduce the main speaker of this wonderful event. Praise the Lord. Are you happy to be here?
Yeah.
I know you are happy to be here. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord God. I see all the pretty faces. Wonderful. Let me begin by these men and women of God who have a strong voice in the earth, in the arenas of jurisdiction, but even beyond the arenas of jurisdiction. We have, coming from Winnipeg, is a long-time friend of mine. God has used him mightily in my life. He can sing, he can preach, he can talk to dignitaries. He just have the easy way to access wherever authority is. Ladies and gentlemen, please appreciate and welcome in our midst, of course, Bishop Dr. Lawrence. God bless you, His Excellencies. I salute you. Please stand up. Can we appreciate him? From Fresh Start, God bless you. Thank you for being here. On his left side, this is the man. Please appreciate with me, Reverend Doctor, His Honorable Ryan Frey. Please stand up. From Transformation Community Center, God bless you, sir. We appreciate your presence. Thank you for being here. And of course, he didn't come alone. He came with the woman that put his life straight. It's not his wife. It's the other one when it gets to the ministry, you know. All right, that's what I'm talking about. She's a mighty woman. I appreciate her so much for the couple days we've been together. Please appreciate Dr. Pastor Tanya. Please stand up. Give her a hand. She worked together with Dr. Frey. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. I will introduce the set man at the right time when he comes to minister. So let me start this way now, rolling down. These are mighty men. I mean, you know, when I look at their lives, all these people sitting here in the front, I feel like I can retire somehow. You know what I'm saying? Because they can roar so strong, they are so powerful, they are so mighty. I'm just a proud father standing here. When I look at you guys and what you guys are doing, I feel so encouraged. Please, ladies and gentlemen, the senior pastor, the set man, the apostolic head over Crosspointe Life Spring from Edmonton, Mr. and First Lady Tumelo. Thank you for being here, Masimba. The Lion! When this guy preaches, you don't want the service to stop. Wow. From Costa Rica, but now is Canadian. Mighty man, a man of great compassion, so generous. Him and his family, they're addicted of Jesus Christ. We love him so much. He's my dear son in whom I am well pleased. Ladies and gentlemen, from Crosspointe Casa de Fe, Pastor Orlando y Pastor Ritana. God bless you. And our only and mighty and wonderful evangelist In fact, we are preparing a trip here from for Burundi, Rwanda, Uganda, and who knows where it's going to end up. Evangelist Lori Martin from Crosspointe of the House. Come on, put your hand together. Appreciate him. God bless you. And this one is dangerous. In the kingdom of darkness, they know his name. And in heaven, they know his name. I love him so much. Wow. An apostolic head. That's the way I call them. Please put your hand together. From Crosspointe Miracle Center, Pastor Joseph and Alde Akier, my youngest leader. God bless you. Come on, appreciate them. Shakaya Balababa. This one, she's not married yet. Just open your eyes. All right? You single people are not married. But you have to be deep in the spirit because she doesn't play around. I am so glad you're here. I didn't expect you to be here, and you made it. You know, she is so powerful in intercession, in preaching of the word, in leadership. And she is running the church in an incredible way in Montreal as well. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hand together for Pastor Delphine, the apostolic head of the church, Crosspointe Nouvelle Alliance. Hallelujah. Are you loving these guys? Thank you for flying 4 hours to be here. And this one, I call him the father of faith. He's like, if his second name should be Abraham or something like that. You know, he packed his 5 kids. The oldest is 11 years old. Going to Ottawa, no job, no nothing. We're going to plant a church. You have to have faith to do that. Am I speaking to somebody? He is a very amazing, amazing man. You know, I shared the testimony with you. How at a very stocky moment of our lives, God brought him to visit us, and he didn't come alone. He brought us a check of $22,000. Can we appreciate him for that? Pastor Christian from Crosspointe Dominion Center, Ottawa. Of course, those were around last night. Last night, Holy Ghost, you guys have a front line popping out. And Pastor Jose, I have to say this. God says he does not look at the outward, but he looks at the heart of man. When I look at this man, does the verse become reality? This man was baptized in water in 2011. At 7 years. Some of you have been born again for 40. You understand? I'm talking about he got baptized in water 2000. Somebody said 2011. But to the glory of God, he's running an amazing church in Toronto called Crosspointe Life Center. Pastor Jose! From the Ivory Coast. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I am excited. I cannot miss the people from the house. I'm jumping over my wife, all right? I will introduce her later, all right? Is that okay? Let me go back here. Thank you for being here. We have on our left side Prophet and Prophetess Okema and Martha. Can we appreciate them, please? I have Pastor Amy. I don't know why Pastor Sibit is. Lobota, you're sitting here and you leave your woman there. What's going on? We are not at the mosque. The men sit with the women, all right? Please appreciate Pastor Sibit and Pastor Amy. God bless you. Thank you for being here. And of course, I'm looking, where is Pastor Joe? He's lost also somewhere. What's going on with these Crosspointe pastors? Anyway, we have Pastor Twee and Pastor Joe doing an amazing job. And of course, the only and powerful one, Pastor Dolores. God bless you, Didi. And ladies and gentlemen, I will not miss. I love her so much, and she knows it. She's precious. God used her in a mighty way in her family to open the door for me for the ministry we have in Nicaragua. Since then, we become like a family. She is mighty. She is wonderful. I love her strength in the spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, appreciate for me, Pastor Nilda Escobar. And of course, you know, His Excellencies today will be sharing with us, and is originally from Jamaica. I was wondering, I was hoping we're going to have a reggae beat going on under the coconut tree style. You know, we have the Jamaican there. Get things happening. Today you are in charge. Today you are in charge. Pastor! I wanted to say with a Jamaican accent, but I haven't practiced. Probably Bithia can help me. Can we say that with a Jamaican accent? Pastor Phil and Jacinth, God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. And we have Mighty. In the physical, he is a sheriff. His jurisdiction extends to Alberta. And in the spirit, he is a dangerous man of God, a pastor. And his jurisdiction has no end, because he has received authority from Jesus Christ. Pastor Kofi and Vero, where she is, stand up there. Can we appreciate them? And on this side, we call him Pastor Shaka. Because when you get close to him, you have to speak in tongues. If you're here, you don't speak in tongues, go hug Pastor Shaka. His name is Pastor Carl, of course, but we call him Pastor Shaka. What a faithful couple. Tomorrow, we're going to have a celebration to honor their family. And of course, Pastor Carl and Pastor Michelle, tomorrow is your day. She will be ordained as a bishop and will shoot her to Nicaragua. Can we appreciate Pastor Carl and Pastor Michelle, faithful in the service of the Lord? And of course, the set man. Yes, come on now. Pastor Jean-Baptiste and Jenny that are not around. God bless you. I want to greet and salute and acknowledge all our leadership and the people of the house who are able to make it today. May the Lord bless you. Our pastoral team, our boards of directors, all the laborers, the workers, the department head, I love you. God bless you so much. And now, I will introduce my wife. My girlfriend of 22 years. You know, she rewrote pastoring as far as I'm concerned. I thought I was a phenomenal pastor. I can build some church and stuff like that. But what she's doing in Montreal blew my mind away. We step out of there by faith. But what I've seen God do through her, and again, she's my wife, of course. But I'm blown away by the work God does through her. And I tell her, and coming from me, it means a lot to her because I am a pastor at core. But she rose a church in an area that is not an easy one. You don't need to learn much to know. The Frenchies don't like much this church thing too much. But yet she went there against all odds, supported by you individually, by this body, by the leadership, and by the people. And they launched out there. This March, they just celebrated 1 year. And right now, they are looking to move from where they are, where they're meeting the afternoon, to find their own place in the morning, because the church is growing. And I want we celebrate her with Rafaela. Where is Rafi? Rafi's in the back. Hallelujah. And they didn't come alone. They came also with, please, ladies, wait. Keep the clapping first. I need to introduce the team, okay? So you get Rafi there, my baby girl. She's not a big girl. My wife here, and we have Emmeline. That is the Claudia of Montreal, all right? Come on, put hands together for them coming from afar. God bless you. Thank you for being here. You may have a seat in the presence of the Lord. We're going to have a dance presentation by our mighty. She's leading our dance ministry, and you're doing an incredible work. Thank you for enrolling the kids and telling them how to worship Abba Father. The stage is yours.
was lost when you found me here. You pulled me close and held me near. And I'm a fool, but still your love. I'll be a fool for the King of Love. You gave me wings so I could fly, and gave me a song to color the sky. And all I have is all from you, and all I want is all of you. It's grace, your grace. When I've walked away, too much to carry, nothing left to say. Forgive me, Lord, when I'm weak and lost, for you traded heaven for a wooden cross. And all these years you carried me, you've been my eyes when I could not see. And beauty grows in the driving rain. You're all of gladness in the times of pain. Your grace, your grace,
your grace. I'm nothing without you.
Your grace,
your grace.
Shine. Oh, it's your grace.
Bless you. Can we celebrate our life again one more time? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jessica. Beautiful. Now I would like to take my time to introduce our guest of honor, a man of great influence that God have chosen for such a time as this to bring to us here in Calgary. Ladies and gentlemen, I will welcome him, His Excellency's Honorable Dr. Philip Fenn. He is Chief Ambassador to the United Nations, Chancellor of SICA, International Universities and Seminaries, and is also the President General of WorldMy, International Third World Leaders Association. Please stand up on your feet as you welcome His most distinguished, His Excellencies, to the podium, walking with Dr. Frey. Hallelujah.
God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Hello. Give a bigger hand than that for the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Raise your right hand. Holy Father, we truly want to thank you for such a time as this. We thank you for what you have already ordained and planned and purpose to be done on this 21st day and as we flow over into the 22nd day. Bless this apostolic convention and let, mighty Father, every promotion, every miracle, every answer to prayer, every breakthrough that you have determined to be done at this time, hour, and season be accomplished. And so, Father, we want to give you thanks in advance. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. I invite you to be seated quietly. Thank you. A pleasant, good evening. I'm just going to request the young man playing on the keyboard to just flow with me a little bit. And before I officially greet anyone, let me declare, since we are in the atmosphere of worship, the prophetic word for the house. Could you project the scripture on the board for me, please? Acts 16, verses 26. Hallelujah. It says what? Can we read together? All right. Hold it there. Everybody say suddenly.
Suddenly.
Everybody say immediately.
Immediately.
Now, I'm going to release this prophetic word based on something that God gave me from this portion of scripture. I was doing a series on the 28 wonders in the book of Acts a few years ago. And this was one of the wonders that I was talking about from the book of Acts. There are three realms in the supernatural. There is the realm of signs, the realm of miracles, and the realm of wonders. Something happened a few years ago. I was in a fasting service, and the Lord said the reason why those manifestations were taking place is because you cross a line into the realm of wonders. So I said, okay, if there is such a realm, let me look for the wonders in the book of Acts. Now, wonder is really an unusual miracle, right? And so this is one of the unusual miracles that occur in the book of Acts. God sent a great earthquake to deliver two preachers from jail. We have never had any record of that before, and we have no record of it happening after. So that's what makes it unusual. And so as I was going along teaching, and I read, suddenly there was a great earthquake so that the foundation of the prisons were shaken. And immediately, and when I get to immediately, everybody say immediately.
Immediately.
It says immediately all the doors were open and everyone's chains were loose. The Holy Spirit highlighted, immediately all the doors were open. And he highlighted that and he asked me a question. He said, how many doors do you want open? What do you think my answer was going to be? Some door? One door? A few door? I'm a greedy man spiritually, folks. So I said, all doors, Lord. And then he said, go proclaim in the hearing of my people. If you discern the time, the hour, and the season that you're living in, go proclaim in the hearing of my people that all doors are now open. Hallelujah. You may want to raise your right hand. And as I begin to be faithful in doing this, the Lord said, how many doors do you think they are? I said, Lord, I don't know. He said, there are 24 major doors. He said, why do you think I have 24 elders in heaven? Each elder control a door. I said, Lord, what are these 24 doors? And I began to speak in tongues and write under the inspiration. And I want to release, stand to your feet, everyone, raise your right hand. I want to release these 24 major doors. I declare that this ministry, Crosspointe, and the apostle, hallelujah, and all the leaders, and all the associates, and all the members, that you are prophetically aligned, and you are set on a path of no return. As you raise your right hand, I release the angel of the angels of the Lord to go forth and open up financial doors, doors of healing, doors that will bring deliverance, peace, joy, favor, love, businesses, education, transportation, missions, prophetic doors, apostolic doors, governmental doors, supernatural doors, property, hallelujah, open, doors of honor, diplomatic doors, doors to nations, doors of cities, doors of opportunities, doors of promotion, and faith door, 24 major door. I declare and decree that all doors are open unto you. Hallelujah. Give the Lord praise in the house. Oh, Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. As you go forward, you have a prophetic word in your mouth. And whenever you see a door, just speak to it and tell it, be open. Doors, be open. You're no longer closed. You are now open. Kariyamasata. And those of you that have been in some difficulties and difficult situations, and even though you have fasted, and even though you have prayed, today is a day, this hour, this time, this season, we want to declare that everyone bands are loose. We want to loose some bondages right now. We want to break some bondages. In the name of Jesus, all bands are loose. All bandages are loose right now. I declare freedom and deliverance in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, glory to God. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. You can be seated. We give the Lord praise. Amen. Well, this evening, let me acknowledge the set man and the first lady of the house, the distinguished, we call him Elijah Diallo. His assistant was trying to help me to pronounce his name, and she said his name is something like Elash. Oh, Lord of mercy. Father, we thank you. We bless the name of the Lord. And distinguished First Lady and family, we want to thank you for the opportunity for inviting me to come and share in this ceremony. I also want to acknowledge my worthy assistant and distinguished representative in this area, His Excellency, the Honorable Dr. Ryan Frey. He's the man that is responsible for this connection, and so I'm thankful. And of course, he has to thank Larry, Bishop Larry, for making the connection as well. So I want to take this opportunity to greet and acknowledge all the ministers of the gospel, all distinguished kingdom ambassadors, saints of the Most High God. A pleasant good evening. Greetings to you in the name of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. I want to run a quick track, and then I'm going to go right into the message. You know, I've been traveled for the last 38 years over 40 countries around the world. There is a cry coming from the body of Christ, and almost everywhere I've gone, there are at least one or two persons asking, man of God, what is my ministry? What is my purpose? What has God called me to do? And, you know, Bishop Ryan, not to be facetious, I always answer this question with another question. And my question has always been, are you an ambassador of Christ? Hallelujah. An apostle, I've never yet gotten a no. Everyone emphatically say, yes, I am an ambassador of Christ. Yet still we find that the Christian ambassador is the only ambassador that does not know his or her commission. Imagine you're telling me you're acknowledging that you're an ambassador of Christ, but at the same time you're asking me, what is my purpose? What am I supposed to do? What is my ministry? All right? But I can't blame you, because I was in the same boat many, many years ago, and God had to take me into the United Nations to let me understand who an ambassador really is. Right? And so I learned, you know, I felt like I was the centurion man who, when he came to Jesus to get his servant healed, and Jesus said, okay, all right, I'll come and heal him. He said, no, Jesus. You don't need to come to my house. I'm not a worthy man. I'm not a Christian man. I'm not even religious for you to come under my roof. But stay right where you are. Speak the word only, because I know that my servant will be made whole. And then he went on to explain. He said, Jesus, I can tell you this, because you see, in the natural realm, I am a man set in authority, and I have soldiers under me, and whenever I want anything done, I don't beg. I give orders. I send to this one, go, and he go it, and to this one, come, and he come it. He said, but spiritually speaking, I have no authority. You have all the spiritual authority. How many of you know that in order to understand spiritual things, we must first know some things in the natural? That Paul, the Apostle Paul, said first the natural, then the spiritual. And I found that we don't understand certain things in the realm of the spirit because we don't understand, you know, the natural stuff. You know, we had a tremendous breakthrough in our ministry a few years ago when the Lord gave me an understanding about the prayer of contract. You know, and if you pass a house and you see a house under contract, what it really means, right? Jesus said, if two or more shall agree as touching anything, it shall be done. And if you understand what a natural contract is, then you can take it over into the realm of the spirit. Hallelujah. And so the Lord had to take me into a natural environment to explain to me who we are as ambassadors. Now I'm very happy that I'm in Canada. And because Canada is a major part of the British Commonwealth. And in the British Commonwealth, they have another word that they use for ambassador. I don't really use the term ambassador in the Commonwealth. They use ambassadors because they have to receive and send ambassador to other nations. But in the Commonwealth, the ambassador is called the High Commissioner. Anybody can agree with me here? All right. Good. Now, because the British Commonwealth is part of what is called the United Kingdom, right, they're using kingdom terms, the High Commissioner. I grew up among evangelical Pentecostal folks, and they told me that Jesus has all called us to carry out the Great Commission. Anybody know that term? All right. So, simply put, every ambassador has to have a commission. So my other question to you is, what has Christ commissioned you to do as his ambassador or as his high commissioner? I have found at least five things. Number one, all of us have been commissioned to go and preach. Number two, all of us have been commissioned to go make disciples. Thirdly, all of us have been commissioned to do deliverance. He said, as you go preaching and teaching, you're going to run into demonized, demon-possessed people. He said, use my name, and my name you shall cast out or expel demons. We call it deliverance. Are we still doing that? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Then he said, you shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Healing ministry. And there is a fifth commission, I believe, that was given after the ascension, on the day of Pentecost. The Holy Ghost was poured out, Peter got up and announced that a prophecy has now been fulfilled. Peter said, as of today, the Lord has poured out his spirit upon all flesh in response to Joel's prophecy. And from this day onward, every son and every daughter shall prophesy. I didn't say prophesy now, I said prophesy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we thank you. So let's recap the five: preaching, teaching, healing, deliverance, and prophetic. Every ambassador, every believing believer is supposed to be flowing in these five areas of ministry as Christ High Commissioner, as Christ Ambassador. Jesus also said in another place, he said, as my Father sent me, so send I you. If you were to work that word from the Greek and get the correct meaning and context, it could be translated this way: as my Father commissioned me, so commission I you. Not only that, but then Jesus also said in another place, he said, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater. So I hope I've helped some folks. No longer do you need to be asking, what is my ministry? What is my purpose? Just touch yourself and say, I am an ambassador. Right. Amen. Father, we thank you. We're ambassadors for Christ. To God be the glory. I believe that every believer has been given three major assignments in life. The most important one, however, is your ambassadorial appointment, right? And I'm going to be giving your apostle, as part of his credential this evening, this little book that I put together, your assignment as an ambassador of Christ. Amen. It's the most important assignment. But in addition to your general assignment as an ambassador of Christ, every one of us have been given what is called special assignments. Everybody say special assignments. There was a day and time in Acts chapter 8 when the evangelist that bear my name, Philip, he got a one-time special assignment. Anybody remember that? The Lord told him, sent an angel to tell him, leave the revival, go and go down to the desert. And when he went down to the desert, he encountered the Ethiopian eunuch. Anybody remember that story? Acts chapter 8. That was a one-time special assignment, right? And God is a very strategic God, you know. He called an evangelist away from a revival to meet with one key leader. You see, leadership are very important. I did a little reading to try and find out whatever happened to that Ethiopian eunuch that got baptized by this evangelist. And I found out that Josephus, the historian, traced that whole encounter to the fact that, you know, that the Ethiopian eunuch took the gospel back to the nation of Ethiopia. God is an awesome God. God can take you away from a crowd and send you to meet one key leader, and by reaching one key leader, you could be touching millions. He's very strategic. Hallelujah. Wonderful. Then we have another example of somebody giving a one-time special assignment. We never heard of this guy anymore. In Acts chapter 9, we heard of a fellow by the name of Ananias, and the Lord spoke to him in a vision and told him to go down to Straight Street, that Saul of Tarsus, you know, needs help. And of course, Ananias was reluctant to go. He said, "You God, are you really sending me to that serial killer, that murderer?" And anyhow, Jesus managed to convince him and said, "Go thy way. This man is not a frozen, but a chosen vessel unto me." All right. So that's an example of what we call a special assignment. The Bible said, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So from time to time, the Holy Spirit is going to put you on special assignments. Great. Then there is that which we call the specific assignment. And The scripture says only some is given the office of apostles, some prophets, some pastors, some teachers, some evangelists, etc., etc. That's what we call specific assignment. But you know, I've run into too many believers who want to run from doing nothing to be named the pastor overnight, or an apostle, or a prophet. Huh? But I believe that if you become a faithful ambassador and start to obey the Great Commission and follow the leading of the Holy Spirit, you know, He will lead you into all the specific things and assignments that He wants you to do. 6 years ago, I was out in Texas, you know, prophetic conference. Never planned this, wasn't on my mind, wasn't part of my ambition. And the Lord spoke to me expressly. Right? When I say expressly, there are times when you get a still small voice in your spirit, and sometimes that one is a little bit difficult to discern if you're not quiet, you know. And that's the primary way I believe God speaks. But in this particular instance, it was when Paul says the Spirit speak expressly. This was what I call an express voice. And I've had a couple of that happen to me. And in that express voice, he said I should set up a university and a seminary, right? And long story short, I obey, and over the last 6 years, we have turned out well over 3,000 graduates covering more than 35 countries around the world. Yeah. I'm saying all of this thing to say to you this evening that if you're searching for specifics, it comes when we first make the decision to be willing and faithful ambassador. The scripture says in Proverb 13:17 up there for me, please. Proverb 13:17. It says, a wicked messenger falls into what? Trouble. But a faithful ambassador brings health. God wants us to be faithful ambassador. You understand? So that everywhere you go, you bring health. Hallelujah. You remember Prophet Elisha walking to the city called Jericho. And when he went walking to the city, the elder said, look at the building, look at everything here. Everything looked good in the natural. But they said to him, man of God, the water is bad. We have barrenness and we have death taking place as a result. The agricultural economy is bad. The water is bad. Situation here is not pleasant. What did the prophet do? He asked for salt. He went to the waters and he poured the salt and prophesied and healed the waters. I've had experience of going to places where they said, for 3 years we have had no rain. I lift my hand up and I said, in the name of Jesus, I command rain. A couple hours later, flood. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. You see, a faithful ambassador brings health. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, turn from the wicked ways, seek my face, God said, I will do what? I will heal, I will forgive the sin, and I will what? Heal the land, heal the economy, bring healing to relationship, bring healing to pocketbooks, bring healing, not just a sick body, but healing, you know, in general. A faithful ambassador brings health. You don't run from Ebola, you don't run from AIDS, you run towards it and command it to die, pass from the body, dry up, you take dominion. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. You know, I have a church in Brompton called No Limits Ministry, and I'm there now. And 6 years ago when I came over, I came in the winter, and we had a little talk to the winter. I said to the snow, I said, listen, we're not going to stop you from falling, but on a Friday night, you don't fall in Brampton. Because we're having miracle services. So we took the minion over the snow, and the snow obeyed. Went right through the whole winter. Never had to close a meeting, you know, on a Friday night. Father, we thank you. You see, I'm talking to you about being ambassadors for Christ. It's not just some little, you know, mental belief. We're talking about walking in authority and in dominion where you don't take no for an answer. The kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. All right. Well, I thought I want to give you that. Let me just share briefly, and I'm going to keep you long this evening. We are here this evening to honor, you know, your apostle in a very unique and special way. And I just want to talk to you a little bit about the importance of honor. All right? Can you bear with me? Hallelujah. Honor started from the very beginning in the book of Genesis. It started with Abraham. And if you would give me Genesis 12:2, let me bring it. Let me establish it right here. Genesis 12:2. God called him away from his own land, and he said to him, I'm going to make you a great nation. I will bless you, and I will make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. Now, your apostle has been a great blessing, you know, to so many people and to all of you. But I stopped by to tell you that God is going to promote him. Amen. In order to make him a greater blessing. Yes. Right? And one of the things that God is going to do to him today is God is going to do something to his name. I'm going to focus on making your name great. Amen. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Making your name great. Now, I know in some circle, you know, they're trying to tell us we're nothing and all kinds of stuff, you know. And we, you know, we use things out of context. You by yourself, yes, we know you're nothing. But remember, the greater one lives on the inside of you. And if you're going to be an ambassador for God, an ambassador for Christ, you can't be nothing. Hallelujah, glory to God. Father, we thank you. You know, when I started realizing who I am and God opened the door for me, I stopped counting the amount of prime ministers, heads of state, heads of government that I prophesied over with accuracy, precision. Oh, glory to God. Pray for some of them to get healed too. Legs grew out and all kinds of stuff happened. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. God wants to make your name great. You have a good name, but God is going to make your name great so that you can become a greater blessing. You said, man of God, where are you going with that? Well, let's go to Psalm 71:21. Let's go to Psalm 71:21. You're doing a good job so far with the board. You shall what? Increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. So David was a great man, was a great king. But at this juncture, he said, God is going to increase my what? Yes, some of you think the only thing God increases is your money. But God wants to increase your greatness. I am talking to great apostles and prophets and pastors and evangelists this evening. But I stop by to tell you that as great as you are, God wants to increase your greatness. Oh, Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. Okay. Let's give me 1 Chronicles 29, verse 10, we're going to go 10, 11, and 12. I want everybody to come with me. 1 Chronicles 29, give me verse 10, then we're going to go 11. Okay, everybody, read with me. Therefore, David blessed the Lord before all the assembly, and David said, blessed are you, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Yours, O God, O Lord, is the greatness, the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty, for all that is in the heavens and in the earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head over all. Both riches and honor come from you, and you reign over all. And in your hand is power and might. And in your hand is to what? Make great and to give strength to a few. Oh, to some, to most, to all. Oh, give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. And keep that last verse there. David said, when I look into the hand of God, I see two things. I see riches and I see honor. Both come from him. But what the church has done, all they have taught us is give honor to whom honor is due. And they taught us prosperity. Thank God for the few churches that teach us to be prosperous, right? But there's no teaching on honor. Hallelujah, Jesus. Marco Sata. But both comes from the Lord. Why just take one and don't take the other? Father, we thank you. You know, Apostle, I am on a rampage honoring kingdom ambassadors because of about 8 years ago what I saw my government in Jamaica did for Usain Bolt. Usain Bolt, of course, 23 years old, broke the world record, became the fastest man on the planet. So on his arrival home, the government decided that they were going to surprise him. So as soon as he landed, they were at the prime minister and the cabinet official, government officials are there waiting to greet him. First thing they did was to confiscate his passport. It was too ordinary. And they threw that in the bin, like how they threw Bin Laden in the bin. And they hand him a red diplomatic passport. And they said to him, son, we know you're just 23, you haven't been to college and all that, but you did so well, we're making you officially ambassador at large. With full diplomatic status. And then while he was trying to digest this, they hit him with another bomb. They said, listen, we have instructed the chancellor of the National University to confer on you. We know you are just 23, you haven't been to college, but we are conferring on you an honorary PhD in human letters. Lord of mercy. And you think they would give him at least a few minutes to recover. They hit him with another bomb. They said, we have further instructed the governor general to confer on you the nation's second highest civilian honor, OJ, not orange juice, but Order of Jamaica. And so at 23, the nation had to address this 23-year-old boy, His Excellency, the Honorable Dr. Usain Bolt, OJ, Order of Jamaica, Ambassador at Large. Now, I mean, everybody was happy, believe me. But then something struck me, and I said, wait. Let's go to Isaiah 43 and verse 4. Since you are what? Precious, precious in my sight. I need the old King James. Sometimes I like the new King James, but sometimes the new one. Yeah. Come on, let's read now. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been what? Honorable. And I have loved thee. Father, we thank you. Hold it there. Now, when Isaiah wrote this, he was not writing this about a sport personality, nor a Hollywood star, or some members of the public that the world would bestow honor upon. He was talking about his own people. Are you with me so far? And what I have found happening is that it is okay for the government to honor the sport personalities and the musicians and so forth. But when it comes to the church, you know, and we're walking to a church, I remember walking to a certain church and they're asking me, and the pastor was in ministry for over 50 years, they're asking me what college the pastor went to so that you come to honor him with an honorary doctorate of divinity. I said, why are you asking me this? In other words, it's okay for somebody at 23 without being to college because they do great work out in the world, you know, sport personality, to get honor. But in the kingdom, it is not okay. Oh, Father, we thank you. You see, you have to understand that whereas I don't have any problem in what the government does in those areas, right, that you cannot lift Hollywood star and sport personality above an apostle or a kingdom ambassador. You have to understand when God said, how precious and how lovely are the feet of him that carry good news. That God said, listen, you are, that word precious, if you do a word study on it, it means you are excellent and honorable in my sight. That's how he looks at his ambassador. Excellent and honorable. Father, we thank you. So I'm giving you a scripture for what I'm sharing with you here this evening. Mighty God, we thank you. So when I saw what the government did and to this young lad, I said, look, I am on a rampage. I am going to honor based on Isaiah 43:4, kingdom ambassadors. Hallelujah. Now, the Lord has enabled me to do this because, you know, when I started my church in Kingston, Jamaica, I came disgust with these deacons taking up the offering and praying, Lord bless those who don't have to give. And at the same time, they're quoting Malachi 3, that the Lord will open the windows of heaven and pour a blessing, and you will not have room to receive it. I said, what hypocrisy? So I went into prayer and fasting. I said, God, something is wrong here. I'm tired of seeing broke tithers. Somebody is telling a lie, but it's not you. Lord, where are we missing it? And as I begin to seek the Lord, he began to give me revelation. And he told me, he said, look, oftentimes I'm telling my people to do things that will bring them wealth, and they're not listening. And because they're not doing it, they're not getting the blessing that they ought to get. In other words, you know, I could be here binding Satan to let go of my money if I didn't obey his voice in Texas to start a university. You understand what I'm trying to say? I would even be here in this meeting. Anyhow, so the Lord took me a little bit further, and I said, Lord, well, how about when we hear you telling us to do stuff and we don't have the means to do it, you know? In other words, if the Lord was to tell you, Dr. Ryan, I wanted to have the biggest food store in Winnipeg, and the first thing you would do is to do your feasibility study. How much is it going to cost? And then, of course, you know, the person who did the study is going to come back with a figure. $5 million. Lord, I don't even have the first $50,000 or the first $10,000. Right? And that was where the Lord said, come with me and I'm going to show you. And he showed me how he started the great church that we're a part of. Not with 30, but with 12. And then, because I was in finance and banking, I switched over and I look at how Kentucky started, I look at how McDonald's started, and all that kind of stuff, and I develop a model called the mustard seed model. Right? Once you have a clear-cut vision on how to, you know, start, you know, from the garage right to the top. Right? And when I did that, we were able to bring unemployment in our local church to zero. Can you tell me which third world pastor have a church with zero unemployment? Well, I was able to achieve that. And the nation of Barbados got into problem with their economy back in the early 1990s. I went in there to help a few believers. They decided that, look, you know, so they practiced what I told them. Within 6 weeks, they called me back. They said, look, we're not going to keep quiet. We're going to put you on national television and we're going to bring the government to hear what you have to say. So they did that. The government got excited. They said, look, oh my God, can you come and make this presentation? We are hosting a United Nations meeting next year on sustainable development. Can you come and make the presentation? So I went and before the UN and I made the presentation. The UN said, what? Can you come to Denmark at the World Summit? We are bringing over 100 world heads together to do this presentation on the mustard seed model. So I said, sure. So we went and we did the presentation. Would you believe it? At the time, myself and the then prime minister, we live on the same road. We met in Denmark. We live on the same road. I couldn't meet him. You know, he had security at his gate. I had none. You know, so I couldn't walk into his house and say, hi, Prime Minister Patterson, how are you? But we met in Denmark at the World Summit. Oh, Father, we thank you. And then from there, the UN says, look, we don't give accreditation to churches. We don't give it to universities, not political party. However, we're looking at your organization to give you consultative status. I said, but we are a church. And the Holy Spirit became my attorney and I filled the application out. One thing led to another. November of 1996, the great announcement came. Word of Life Christian Fellowship, a full gospel, tongue talking, you know, foot stamping, hand clapping, hallelujah shouting church, created history. Till today, we're the first and we're the only full gospel church that have consultative status in the United Nations. Hallelujah. And every single year, I have to accredit 17 ambassadors to fill all the UN offices around the world, not counting how many ambassadors at large and special envoy, you know, that we send to different places like the White House, World Health, World Bank, etc., etc. So we are invading territories all over. Hallelujah. Let me give you a few more scriptures, and I'm moving ahead. Let's look at the 75th Psalm. Let's look at the sixth verse, verse 6, 7, and then we're going to do verse 10. Hallelujah. It says, for promotion cometh, neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. Notice it didn't say the north. God is the judge. He put it down one and he set up another. Give me the last verse, verse 10. Yeah. All the horns of the wicked also will I cut off, but the horns of the righteous shall be exalted. Everybody say, that's me. I'm righteous. My horn shall be exalted. Hallelujah. Now notice it says there in the sixth verse, it says, promotion cometh. Everybody say, promotion cometh. See why I like the whole King James Version? What does cometh mean? It means present continuous tense, eh? Keep flowing. It's like faith cometh by hearing the word. Joy, my cousin cometh in the morning. My help cometh from the Lord. But I'm talking about promotion right now. Promotion cometh. Promotion cometh. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Come on, raise your right hand and say, promotion cometh. Every person with your right hand raised, I want you to just wave it before the Lord. I want to pray for your promotion, because promotion cometh. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you that we are in a season and a time of promotion. And I thank you that promotion cometh, like faith cometh, like joy cometh. It never stops. Lord, thank you for taking your people from faith to faith, from glory to glory, from strength to strength. Increase them more and more in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Give the Lord a hand. Psalm 92:10. Let's run over there quickly. Psalm 92:10. But my own shall thou exalt like the horn of the unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Let me explain this verse to you. The psalmist David was saying, or the psalmist was saying, I'm going to get a promotion. I'm going to get a promotion. Come on, tell your neighbor, I'm going to get a promotion. Come on, say, I'm going to get a promotion. Finally, Dr. Ryan couldn't take it anymore. He said, David, how do you know you're going to get a promotion? He said, listen, I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Every time you walk into an apostolic conference like this, on any meeting, and a prophet or an apostle picked up oil, get ready. I feel like I'm here to anoint one person with oil. Father, we thank you. Every time David was anointed with oil, what happened? God moved him to promotion. He was just a shepherd boy when he was anointed by Prophet Samuel. And God moved him from being a shepherd boy to becoming a prince. That was his first promotion. Then the second time he was anointed with oil that we have record for, God moved him from a prince to becoming a king, but a limited king, because it was only king over one tribe. Only the tribe of Judah followed him. But the third time he was anointed king over all Israel. So every step of the way that David was anointed with fresh oil, there was a promotion. Distinguished lady who asked me if I need anything, can you get the oil for me? I need the oil now. Get me that bottle of oil. Okay, so it's going to be serious inside here this evening. Lord have mercy. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. I remember one time I anointed a couple with fresh oil. Their business was flat. 30 days later, they signed a contract for the equivalent of about $10 million. Anoint a fellow with fresh oil and anoint a house that he said he wanted, but he needed a job before he could get the house. In a time of recession, right there in Atlanta, 7 days later, he got one of the best jobs, best IT job, and he was able to get a five-bedroom house. Hallelujah. He opened his living room area, which was very huge, and every 60 days for 11 years straight, I flew in and out of Atlanta doing what we call the School of the Holy Spirit. People were coming from all over, you know, to get the prophetic word and to get, you know, personal ministry. Hallelujah. I could tell you all different kind of story about when the Lord moved to anoint somebody with oil, with fresh oil. My horn shall thou exalt, thy the horn of a unicorn. I'm going to get a promotion. How do you know you're going to get a promotion? I shall be anointed. Bring the oil, please. Yeah, I might use this one too, but, you know, I'm not sure if they believe in this one. So, hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. What is about to happen to your apostle this evening is that he is on a collision course with the scripture that I'm about to tell you to look for. He has done something, and this scripture is about to be fulfilled in his life tonight. And I'm speaking of none other than Psalm 112 and verse 9. Put it up there. And if this testimony is not true, then I'm out of order. He had dispersed. He had given to the poor. His righteousness endured forever. His horn, which means his authority, shall be what? Exalted with honor. Is that true of your apostle?
Yes.
Good. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. Jesus himself said, a prophet is never without honor, except, of course, among his own people in his own little hometown. Hallelujah. We give God thanks. We give him praise. Honor, saints of God, is very, very important. It comes from God. Just like wealth and riches come from him, honor comes from him. We have a president in the United States right now that is not the salary why he ran for president. It's the awesome honor that the office carry, because he's not taking a salary. Previously, we had a mayor in the city of New York, Mayor Bloomberg, a billionaire, didn't take a salary. Employed his daughter to work with him, paid her $1 just for the accounting sake. Didn't need the money. But the honor of being the mayor of the financial capital of the world and the largest city in America means more to him than millions. Honor, saints of God, is priceless. It's priceless. But it comes from God. Because God said it. He said, and you don't have to look for this one, but you can write this one down. In 1 Samuel 2:30, he says, those who honor me, I will honor. I want you to leave the scripture there. Because the Lord, I set aside this meeting. Apostle, I know I'm here specifically to bestow the ambassadorial appointment and all that. But if afterward you give me a few minutes, as the Holy Spirit lead me, to just put a little oil in a few. Right? I didn't plan this. And honestly, I didn't plan this. But somebody's pulling on something. You Africans, you know how to pray. I know that. And somebody's pulling on something. And I need permission to obey God. All right? But let me not take anything away from the original assignment that I'm here for. Apostle, I'm going to ask you to come on the platform, and then I'm going to ask Dr. Ryan to come and assist me here. The first thing I'm going to do is to ask Ambassador Ryan to read the ambassadorial appointment, and then I'm going to present that first, followed by his chaplaincy diploma, chaplaincy license, and then, of course, the official badge. Is she going to read it? Okay.
ambassadorial appointment. Whereas the United Nations is the highest international body, whereas Word of Life Christian Fellowship, otherwise called Word of Life Ministries International, and thereafter shall be called WOLMI, being the first and only full gospel organization to be accredited by the United Nations Economic and Social Council, whereas WOLMI has been given the rights to appoint ambassadors to the United Nations at large and to the intergovernmental bodies, whereas the Executive Council, having vested in the President the authority to appoint, promote, and accredit Kingdom ambassadors within the guidelines of its Constitution, whereas His Excellency, the Right Reverend, the Honorable Dr. Philip S. Finn, Commander of the Most Distinguished Order of Extraordinary Ambassadors and President General of WOLMI, hereby appoint His Excellency, Reverend Dr. Ilhaj Diallo, CDKA, Commander of the Most Distinguished Order of the Kingdom Ambassadors, with all rights and privileges pertaining thereto, of being an ambassador. Whereas he has the right to use the title ambassador before his name and the letter CDKA after his name. Whereas the title ambassador is after the order of Ephesians 6:20 and from the Kingdom of God Constitution according to 2 Corinthians 5:20, given under my hand and the Executive Council of WOLMI on the 10th day of June 2018. The Right Reverend Dr. the Honorable Philip S. Finn, OEA, DCPC, President General. And Reverend Dr. the Honorable Sharon J. Bakido Finn, OEA, OPC, Main Ambassador to the UN Headquarters, New York.
It's all pleasure. It's an honor to be a part of your life and to see the grace that God has placed upon your life. I present your diploma and I thank God for the favor again once more.
Put it this way. Congratulations. Okay. Wait. Let me explain this before we give it a mic. One moment. Where's the mic?
Sorry?
Oh. Test. Now we have one more thing to do. And we're going to present the ID and the official badge. I know many chaplaincy just give you a little ID to work with. And we give you the kind of a tool, not only to the diploma and the license and everything is good for his office. But when he's out on the road, working, he's going to need this. also want to take this opportunity to present him one of my little booklet that I wrote, Your Assignment as an Ambassador of Christ. Last but not least, I don't know if you could bring a pillow or something. I'm going to ask him to kneel. I'm going to ask the presbytery to come and join me. He wants his family to be with him, please. Just come draw near. Just come right beside him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you can. One of you can come on this side. Yeah. Bishops, apostles, as we read in the Word of God. Psalm 92 and the 10th verse. My arm shall thou exalt like the horn of the unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Father, we thank you that promotion cometh unto your apostle, unto your son, at this time, hour, and season. We're asking you, mighty God, to bless him indeed. Enlarge his territory. Let your divine hand of favor, let your hand that bring promotion, protection, healing, health, and strength be his portion. We prophetically align him and we shoot him forth. And we set him on the path of no return. We release four levels of consistent promotion. Number one, from faith to faith. Number two, from glory to glory. Number three, from strength to strength, Psalm 84 and verse 7. And number four, from wealth to wealth. As it is written, the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. Mighty God, we thank you that this authority will flow over to his lovely wife as we anoint her as well. With fresh oil for promotion and his beautiful young daughter here. Father, we give you praise and any other members of the family. Mighty God, we want to thank you and we want to bless you. Lord, just as how David said, thou shalt increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. Just as how you told Abraham that you would make his name great, you have determined that on this day, Almighty Father, to make this mighty apostle name great. Greater than it has ever been before. You have now raised him to another dimension. You have now enlarged him to another level of ministry. And you're saying to him, welcome to the Acts 9:15 assignment. And I want you to put Acts 9:15 up there quickly for me, that everybody can see it. Acts 9:15. Like the Apostle Paul, this is what is determining upon your apostle here. The Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me, to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. No limits. You're going to bear the name of the Lord before kings, government officials. You're going to bear the name of the Lord before Jews and Jewish people. And of course, you're going to bear the name of the Lord as you've been doing before the nations. Threefold assignment. Paul the apostle was the only apostle in the New Testament that was given a threefold assignment. And this threefold assignment has now been given to this church, this apostle. Hallelujah. I mean, he's just the leader. Others of you are going to follow behind. Hallelujah. So get ready for this. you know, for the threefold apostolic assignment. Get ready, my man of God, to meet with heads of state, prime ministers, government officials, ambassadors. Hallelujah. Get ready, man of God, for a new prophetic mantle that will be in your mouth, so that when you meet with them, the wisdom of God will flow and you will bring accurately the word of the Lord. You will also bring the word of the Lord to deal with crisis and difficult situation like Joseph. For the Joseph anointing and the Daniel anointing, you're a prophet statesman, you're an apostle statesman. The hand of the Lord, God, rest upon you. Hallelujah. So get set and get ready. Your future is more powerful than your past. Hallelujah. Your future is brighter than the midday sun. Hallelujah. Tonight you're getting a double for your trouble, a triple for your tribulation, and a quadruple for your promotion. The hand of the Lord is upon you. Hallelujah. To do your good. Your best is yet to come. Hallelujah. Because your future is more powerful than your past. The glory of God. Give the Lord a wave. Give the Lord back. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We praise you. Korea Masata Raman. Lobondo Robekeshenda. Yes. Korea Masata Ramakotu Robesenda. Come on. Let's look to the Lord right now. Kondo Rebecca Shetia Roba Koroba Karabedenda. Kondo Rabaka Shandarana.
Hallelujah.
Very quickly, I'm going to ask all the ministers in the front row to just meet me at the altar right here.
Just to see you, to behold you as my King, for your glory.
No, first lady, you've already been ministered to. You get it already. All right. All right.
I will do.
Man of God, are you ready for your promotion? I'm just going to put your oil first. Hallelujah, glory to God.
To behold you as my
Father, we thank you. Glory
for your glory.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
I will do.
Man of God.
Anything.
Distinguished ambassador.
Just to see.
Distinguished ambassador.
To behold you for your glory, I will do it just to see you, to behold you as my King for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, to behold you as for your glory. I will do anything just to see. Be where you are.
Gotta be where.
Not shut it off, just lower it. Just. Can I get I'm gonna pray for you differently because I know you're pregnant, but in the name of Jesus, Lord, thank you, mighty God. Thank you for what promotion you have for her and for her household. We release it in the name of Jesus. We give you a lot of thanks. Hallelujah. Just hold her there for me. Don't let her go down. All right. I need, I'm going to do a 7 at a time. I need 7 men to stand behind. So you can go back to your seat. You can go back to your seat. You stay right here. I want you to be in a huddle like this for me. 7 of you in a huddle. Yeah. 7 at a time. In a huddle. Huddle, huddle. Huddle, huddle. Huddle. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now 7, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need 7 men behind. I want you all to just release yourself into the Lord. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. 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 Hallelujah. I need 7 men behind. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. And get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Father, we thank you. Name of Jesus. Hallelujah. All right. Just lay them out there. Lay them out there. I need the 7 men to come behind. Come step forward. Step forward. Get in a huddle. Get in a huddle. Get in a huddle. Get in a huddle. 7 of you. Are you part of this? Come, 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 come. Come. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Come on. I want you all to be praying, be praying, be praying. Lose yourself in the Lord. Be praying in tongues. Come on, lift up your voice. Be praying, be praying, be praying, be praying, be praying, be praying. Come on, get ready for fire. Get ready for fire. Get ready for fire. Get ready for fire. Get ready for promotion. Get ready for fire. Get ready for fire. Get ready for fire. Get ready. 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 Come on. Come on, give the Lord a wave. Give the Lord a wave in the place. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Don't be distracted. Don't be distracted. It's not a show. Come on, let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. Let's worship. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Come on, get ready to move to the next level. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Huddle, huddle, huddle. Get into a huddle. Huddle, huddle, huddle. Pray, 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 pray. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing for your glory. Just to see you, to behold you as my, wanna be where you are. Get into a huddle.
Wanna be where.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Huddle, 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 huddle.
Wanna be where you are.
Get into a
Gotta be Gotta be where you are. For your glory. Just to see you, to behold you as my King, for your glory, yeah. I will do anything just to see you.
Send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send your spirit. Come on. Send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing. Lord, send your
send your glory down. Send the winds of refreshing, God, send your spirit. Send the winds of refreshing, God, send your glory.
For your glory.
are. Come on, I want you to step forward, step forward, step forward.
Where you are.
Okay, all right. Begin to pray, begin to pray, begin to bring tongues, bring tongues, bring tongues. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Are you ready? Are you ready? Step forward a little, step forward a little. Huddle, huddle, huddle. Lock arms, lock arms and pray. I want you to begin to pray. Come on, come on, come on. You have no, these guys haven't gotten any oil. Get some oil for 1, 2, 3. Onoramanda. Otorabakashataramanda. Alright. Be prayerful. Lift up your voice and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Lift up your voice and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Lift up your voice and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Get ready for a promotion. Get ready for a breakthrough. Get ready for a breakthrough. Woman of God, are you ready? 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 Are you ready?
He's jealous for me. Love's like a hurricane. I am a tree.
Step forward. Come on.
Bending beneath.
Some of you are not ready.
How he loves us so.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
How he
are you
loves
ready?
How he loves us. Say, oh. No. How he loves us so. Oh, how he loves.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Let me have your attention, everyone. Koryama sata ramakashata. Lebande rebeke shete rebaka ramasata. Roboko shete rebe sende rebeke te rebe korobidendo. Labande rebeke shende ramananain. Labando roboko soto romoko romoko rovidendo. Hallelujah. I want to close with a portion of scripture from Daniel. Give me Daniel chapter 1 and the 12th verse. What does it say? Prove thy servants, I beseech thee, 10 days. Hallelujah. Let's go to verse 15. Verse 15. At the end of 10 days, your countenance appear fairer and fatter in flesh than all the children which eat the portion of the king's meat. Daniel make up a decree. Thou shalt decree a thing, the scripture says, and it shall be established. He said, in 10 days, we're going to get a miracle. In 10 days, Isaiah 58 and verse 8 is going to be fulfilled in my life, in the life of Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. Yeah. Well, I want you to raise your right hand. For the sake of time, we could not have prophesied over everyone. Hallelujah. But I want to declare this. Prove thy servant 10 days. I want to make a divine decree that 10 days from today, it don't have to be 10 days exactly, because a couple of you will have what we call the tomorrow about this time miracle, the 72-hour miracle, the right now miracle. But between now and day 10, I want you to raise that right hand and wave it to the Lord. I'm going to lock you into a divine decree like Daniel. Why did Daniel say, prove thy servant 10? Because of the significance of the number 10. 10 commandments, prove obedience. 10 plagues, prove deliverance. 10 part of your money, tithe, prove God in your finance. Daniel said, prove thy servant 10 days. God doesn't need 10 days to do a miracle, but it's a point of contact. Between now and day 10, hallelujah. I said, between now and day 10, I make a defined decree that every one of you with your right hand raised will receive a miracle of favor. A miracle of favor. Come on, wave that right hand. Wave that right hand. Wave that right hand. Wave that. Father, in the name of Jesus, by divine decree, I ask you to bless everyone indeed. Enlarge their territory. Promote them, Lord. Hallelujah. Let your divine hand of favor. Let your hand of prosperity. Let your hand of protection. Let your hand that bring promotion be upon their life. And as a sign, let everyone receive a 10-day miracle. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. To God be the glory. Doctor.
Lord, I would like you to stand up on your feet if you can. And one more time, thank you to Dr. Honorable His Excellency's Finn to have come and impacted this body of believers to such an extent. We salute you, sir. We thank you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless Dr. Frey for your heart. Kingdom Bridge, that's the way I call it. I love you, brother. God bless you so much. May the Lord bless Bishop Dr. Larry. We call him Larry, but it's Lawrence. I love you. We've been together for so many years. I remember one day I was in Edmonton in a conference, and after I finished to share, I was just a young pastor of four years, and he walked to me, and he said, I want to tell you something, but don't get offended. I said, just tell me. He said, you know what? You're underrated for what you carry. I walk out of that. I say, what the heck is he talking about? But I guess God used it as a bridge to bring a connection so that today God can honor me one more time. God bless you so much. You prophesy and God used you to bring the answer. I want to greet all our board of directors and pastors and the apostolic heads that have come from Ottawa and Montreal, Toronto, from Calgary, from Edmonton, represented from Nicaragua to Costa Rica, from India, from Jamaica, and all, and Vietnam as well. Glory to God. I am just really tender-hearted. I don't know what to say, all right? It doesn't happen often. I just don't know what to say. I'm just grateful for your lives. You know, this could have been done somewhere else. And I spoke to him, I said, you know, I don't want this to be done in Winnipeg or in New York or in Detroit. I want we do it to honor my people. Because we are family. And we become so close that it's like anything major in my life, I have to ensure that you are there. And so I ask him, please, can we report this thing and do it in our own house? And I told him, I don't want just a governmental thing. I want church style. And how many people were blessed by the anointing upon the life of this man of God? Hey! So today I'm a very complete man because he did it beyond and above what we expected. He came and established government in the proper order according to divine wisdom. And we love it so much. And I want to let you know we're going to have a little, you know, sharing there in the foyer, of course. But let me reemphasize again. I am grateful to God, to my family, to the leaders in this house, to the whole body, to those who have come from abroad, to the apostolic pastors. I have no word. I'm just grateful to all of you, from the worship team to all the department. And I say it, I'm going to say it again. We have become so much family. I love you dearly. This is no longer just church. This is family. Thank you for the honor that you have brought to us. And thank you for being witnesses of what God is doing. Keep me in prayer. I was talking to him. I said, you know what? I don't know. What do I do next now? And he said, okay, in September 1st weekend, you need to make sure you come to Geneva at the UN headquarters there. We're going to use one of the rooms to do diplomatic training. I guess he wonder all these pastors have no clue of diplomacy. You know what I'm talking about? We can flow in the Holy Ghost, but there are some protocol we need to learn. So I think my first class will be September the first weekend in Geneva, in Switzerland, in So to learn about protocol, diplomacy, and all this other stuff that we know in the head, but we got to walk it out. But thank God for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. God bless you. And please, let's celebrate Christ again and give him a shout of praise in the house. Hallelujah. Hey. Thank you, Lord. And tomorrow. Where is Pastor Michelle? Now, you know, you will not only get blessed by an apostolic anointing. You're going to have the full load of all these mighty men here, ambassadors, honorable excellencies, and all these offices. You will take it to Nicaragua and you will command that the crisis come to an end in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So tomorrow at 10 o'clock, invite somebody. He will be ministering. We will be ministering together. We'll have a lot of good testimonies.
and we're going to honor this couple, the Baileys, tomorrow in this very place. Please give a hug, and if God put on your hand to give a Pentecostal shake to all our pastors that have come from abroad, do so and encourage them. And see you tomorrow. Hug somebody in the foyer to share something.
We be a church ready for you.
Even so come, Lord Jesus.